His Excellency, hello.
Hi.
This is Nasser Kamal, he's the Secretary General of the Union pour la Méditerranée.
Vous voulez faire en français, on peut le faire en français.
On peut le faire en français aussi.
Vas-y,
you have
vas-y.
Blue eyes, it's amazing. Ouais, vous avez très beaux yeux.
Ouais, c'est la Méditerranée, non?
C'est la Méditerranée.
Ouais. Les yeux étaient noirs avant d'arriver ici.
and I suspected you were blonde-haired too, no?
I was.
Ouais, voilà, c'est
and
ça.
My father comes from Upper Egypt.
Upper Egypt. Yeah.
Yeah, yes, from the south of Egypt, and he was blonde.
He was blonde, voilà, c'est ça. Blond aux yeux bleus et égyptien, c'est absolument pas incompatible pour ceux qui imaginent que.
Pas incompatible.
Voilà, exactement. Je suis ravie d'être là. Thank you so much for inviting me to be here. And I would just ask some of my colleagues too, because I'm talking with His Excellency here, so please be quiet. Thank you very much. And actually, we were talking yesterday, and they present us a project of collaboration entre deux pays pour la désalinisation de la bande de Gaza. Et c'était un projet collaboratif super qui a mis plein de personnes autour d'une même table. They managed to gather almost 500 million euros. For this project, or
for
even more,
yes.
Et c'est bientôt. They will soon start the realization of this project. Mm-hmm. So congratulations, it's a good job. My question is, how could we possibly imagine that this project could be taken into a more political level, so that it can contribute to peace between Palestine and Israel?
Well, your colleague said, "Je voulais que je parle en français, en anglais."
Ouais, most convenient, comme
le
vous voulez.
C'est quoi
les deux? Comme vous voulez. C'est français, anglais, les deux.
C'est les deux. Well, your colleague was saying I will be asking you some political question. We approach politics from a different angle in the UFM, meaning what we handle, especially in the South region that is ridden with conflicts. Some of them are now like the Arab-Israeli conflict. Has been with us for decades. Others are recent, post-2011, like in Syria and others. Our approach is not on conflict resolution as much as it is dealing with the root causes.
It is not. And I understand it is not a political organization.
No. We are everything in the world is political to a certain extent, because water. Water policy is politics.
Politics.
Environmental
is politics.
Climate change is. But our direct approach is more working on the root causes and creating a conducive environment and enhancing regional integration. So I will compare ourselves in a very humble way because there is no, the scale is so different to the idea of Schuman. What did Schuman do in the early 1950s? He created a community of interest around steel and coal, so war would be impossible in Europe. And he did succeed. So this organization, DNA, is based exactly on the same premises, of course, on a much lesser scale and smaller scale, is to create the objective condition that make the possibility of conflict in the region less likely. So when you talk about the Gaza desalination plan, well, you the Gaza area, 2 million Palestinians do not have access to clean water. The aquifer that Gaza is getting its water from is now polluted, depleted, and that is leading to more social unrest, to instability, and giving rise to extremism and what have you.
Yeah.
So by dealing with the water of issue, which is a development issue, we are working on the political dimension of things by creating better living conditions for the Palestinians.
I agree, but this is indirectly. Don't you think exactly because you are not a political organization, maybe you can be and have a leading position, leading role into conducting
but I cannot,
the peace.
I cannot say we are not apolitical because we are governed by the 43 member states at the political level by their foreign ministers. We discuss actually the situation in the region, including the Arab-Israeli conflict.
But earlier you said it was not fulfilled.
Our main area of intervention of activity are focused on human development and sustainable development. So we contribute because others are doing
the conflict. Yeah, but they're not doing good.
Well, good or not good, those who are working on conflict management, on conflict prevention, on even negotiating possible solutions to different crises in the region, are doing their job. We are joining them by creating the right condition and creating an infrastructure that is conducive for an area, for a more peaceful area, an area, well, that's not going to happen tomorrow or the day after tomorrow, but for creating the right condition for regional integration, for more understanding, for synergies, for dialogue between youth in the region,
But we agree on all that, but what we need today also is a political will from the leaders, from the political leaders. So I was just wondering whether you as an organization could actually help them just sit together and talk, which is not really the
case. By the way, they are sitting together and talking most of the time, but the problem does not lie there. But actually, we do contribute in explaining to our member states the reality of the situation in the region when it comes to shortcomings in socioeconomic fields, poverty, lack of infrastructure, women empowerment, because we think if women are empowered in our region, that would be very important. I keep looking at you. You want me to look at your beautiful gadget?
All these matters, and it's very important.
But no. If your answer and the straightforward answer, are we the one providing a platform for political dialogue on crises and conflict in the region? The short answer would be no.
Well, but at least you try to put a good
create the condition,
environment,
inform the member states, deal with the root causes of those conflicts. The answer is yes.
Do you have the courage of your opinion?
My personal?
Yeah.
Or as the Secretary General of the UFM?
Maybe, I guess both.
As the Secretary of the UFM, I present the collective will of the member states. So I have to be careful when I comment on a subject or another. But we can have lunch later and talk about my own personal opinion.
Okay, it's going to be off. But thank you very much, the UFM, for setting this environment. And we hope we get a platform to further develop this path for peace in the whole region.
I'll be more direct by telling you we don't lack platforms. What we lack is political will.
And action. Thank you so much.